Hi friends, let us see how can we utilize a bilinear transformation method in solving a problem. Let us take up a problem. Given is HA of S as S plus 0.1 divided by S plus 0.1 the whole square plus 16, and they have said that the resonant frequency requirement omega r of the digital filter is pi by 4, pi by 2. So let us change it to pi by 2 rather than pi by 4. Let us take it as pi by 2. Now, whenever you solve a bilinear transformation method, the solution is we will replace, or we know that H of S is equal to H of Z if I substitute S is equal to 2 by T 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. So if I replace all S's in the given transfer function into H of S, I am going to get H of Z. Now we need to obtain this T. So how to obtain this T? So to obtain this T, we will use this and something from this. In general, a transfer function of analog filter is written as S plus A upon S plus A the whole square plus omega C square. So this term actually gives you the cutoff frequency. So this term is responsible to give us a cutoff frequency. So let us, so the cutoff frequency in this case is 4 radians per second. So I have received the cutoff frequency as 4 radians per second from the given data. Now we have the cutoff frequency of analog filter. We know what cutoff frequency does digital filter demands. From there I can easily calculate my T. So how to calculate T? For that we have a relation of omega. That relation says capital omega is equal to 2 by T tan of omega by 2. Now we know this omega, we know this omega also, so I can easily calculate my T. So let us rearrange this equation. I want T, so I'll put T over there, then 2 by omega tan of omega by 2. So here I will use omega C and omega R. So that will give me 2 upon 4 tan of, here it is pi by 2, so I'm going to get pi by 4, right? Because the given omega R is pi by 2. So I'm going to get pi by 4, so that T is 1 by 2. So I got capital T as 1 by 2 seconds. So we got capital T. Now we have to just replace our H of S and get H of Z. So I can write as H of Z equals to H A of S if S is equal to 2 by T 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. Okay, so H of Z will be equal to, our HA of S was S plus, so I will write first here S plus 0.1 divided by S plus 0.1 the whole square plus 16, and I have to substitute S as 2 by T is 1 by 2, so it will be 1 by 2, which will be 4 ultimately, so 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse. Okay, now let us do that. So replace all S's with 4 into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse plus 0.1 divided by, here I will also have 4 in the capital bracket, 4 into 1 minus Z inverse upon 1 plus Z inverse plus 0.1, and this whole raised to 2 plus 16. Okay, Let us solve this. Now, to solve this problem, I will get this as 4. In the numerator, I will make it as 1 minus z inverse plus 0.1 into 1 plus z inverse, the whole divided by 1 plus z inverse. Okay, divided by, this will be again, I'll keep as 4 into 1 minus z inverse plus 0.1 into 1 minus 1 plus z inverse, okay, the whole square divided by, let us make it the whole divided by, because I have 16 over here, so I'll put plus 16 into 1 plus z inverse the whole square, and I will write it as 1 plus z inverse the whole square. What I did was, I have brought this denominator multiplied over here. There will be a whole denominator. I have divided the squares and have multiplied this over here. Now I will cancel 1 square and 1 plus z inverse, and then this will go in the numerator. So it will be now 4 into 1 minus z inverse plus 0.1 into 1 plus z inverse the whole multiplied by 1 plus z inverse divided by, here either you can open it up now or you can keep it as it is. So this will be 4 into 1 minus z inverse plus 0.1 1 plus z inverse the whole square plus 16 into 1 plus z inverse the whole square, and the final answer of this equation will be 0.128 z square plus 0.006 z minus 0.122, okay, the whole divided by z square plus 0.123 times of 0 into 6 z plus 0.975, which is my h of z. If in exams you do not have enough time to solve this problem, you can leave the problem at this step. There's no issues. Or you can go one step further and keep everything in terms of z raised to minus 2 and leave the problem. There's no harm in that. Okay, so or else you can go on solving. If you have a lot of time, you can go on solving and reach till this step. From here to here, there are many steps in between, which I have skipped. But the readers are encouraged to solve the steps and find this answer as a solution. Thank you.